So today I'd like to present you our recent findings about the ground states of the polar lattice of heavy water molecules in beetle crystal. And I'd like to start with motivation behind this study. And the motivation is to explore the phase diagram of matter which produced by dipole-dipole interaction. The dipole-dipole interaction is quite interesting. Here you can see the formula. And from this formula, we can see what this interaction is characterized by a long range. The dipole-dipole interaction is long range and anisotropic. And these two features leads to new peculiar ground states. And the most famous one in the classic world is the normal field instability in ferrofluid air interface, when in strong magnetic field we can observe appearing of triangle lattice of spikes on the surface. In a quantum world, recently the supersolid state was observed, which is stabilized by a dipole-dipole interaction. Also, utilizing the dipole-dipole interaction, we can build the quantum simulator of spin lattices and even a quantum computer. So the motivation behind the study is quite strong, but how can we realize such system, such lattices of interacting dipoles? The two main ways is to use the cold atoms and some crystalline interfaces that we can localize the separate molecules. And here you can see the lattice of beryl crystal, which forms the triangle lattice of nanocages. In those nanocages, single water molecules might be localized. The localization can be of two types. The water, the first type, we call it water one. Then the single water molecules localized in nanocage can freely rotate. And the water two types, then water molecules is strongly coordinated by the ion in the bottleneck. So it's almost completely fixed and cannot rotate. In this way, when we have this beryl crystal with non-localized polar molecules, effectively we have the triangle lattice of freely rotating and interacting dipoles. And recently, the two phenomena was observed in such system. The first one is a quantum paraelectricity of such an ensemble of light water molecules. And in Cardioid crystal, which is just have a slightly lower symmetry, we observe the phase transition to ordered phase with coexistence of ferroelectric and antiferroelectric ordering. And now we can ask ourselves a question: how we can tune this dipole lattice to other phases? And one of the approach which used for different quantum paraelectrics is isotope substitution. Here you can see a picture for strontium titanate, the substitution of oxygen to heavy isotope leads to transition from quantum paraelectric behavior to a real phase transition to ordered phase. So to do the isotope substitution, we grow the beryl crystal with heavy water inside. Here you can see the IR absorption spectra, where you can see the distinct peaks for water, heavy water one and heavy water two molecules. So we very well characterized this sample. And here you can see the example of IR maps, which is basically the IR spectra taken at different points, and we integrate the distinct peak for water one and get the map of distribution of water one. From this picture, you can see what water one is very homogeneously distributed across the sample. And we also can plot the map of water two distribution. And here you can see only traces of water two molecules. So we can conclude what in our sample, the water in our sample is all, is almost all water in our sample is of type 1, the freely rotating one. And in this sample, the dielectric properties, in contrast to the previously studied light water beryl, the in the temperature dependence of permittivity after following the Kerr-Weiss, we observed a saturation of permittivity. Here we can see the qualitatively different behavior. The permittivity at high temperatures first follows the Kerr-Weiss behavior, but after that, the permittivity goes downward at around the Curie temperature, around 2 Kelvin. And this is the typical signature of the phase transition. We also measured the field dependence, but our sample almost didn't show any dependence on the constant DC field applied to a sample. And this behavior is might be understood from the imaginary part of permittivity, from a spectra of imaginary part. Here you can see the spectra at different temperatures here, and in the log-log plot, you can see what after cooling down below the 2 Kelvin, the white absorption band start appearing at the low frequencies for 4 magnitude of frequency. To better understand what happened in our system, we also did the targets and microwave measurements at different temperatures, and combining all the data together, we can plot the extremely wide band spectra of permittivity. And here you can see what the at the temperatures above the phase transition, above 2 Kelvin, 4 Kelvin, for example, you can see what the main features here is two absorption peaks, which along with the specific heat data, which we also measured. There we observed the Schottky anomaly in the specific heat contribution from the water lattice. This Schottky anomaly shows tells us what in the system there is two distinct levels with a spacing between them around 15 Kelvin in temperature units. So along with these data, we can plot the next picture. Here you can here we present the level structure of the water molecule in sand beryl. We just took the simple quantum harmonic oscillator in 6 well potential, which gives us splitting to 6 levels. But after applying the rotational symmetry responding to crystal, we got the degeneracy of 4 levels, and that gives us 4 level structure. This is the basic the level structure of water molecule in the nanocage. We can plot it for different height of the potential for different well of external potential. But in real crystal, the symmetry is not exactly PR3. The symmetry might be slightly breaking, might be slightly broken, and the degeneracy might be lifted. So we got the small splitting of two degenerate level, and we have the two level system between the ground state and first excited state. And this level structure fits well with our measured spectra. This frequency falls, the frequency, low frequency absorption line is less than a gigahertz range. It corresponds to a split level, and the terahertz line is the corresponds to the transition to level. But that's the picture for one molecule, one quantum rotator. But the dipole interaction between our rotators gives us the splitting of a ground state into lots of levels due to inhomogeneity and range dependence of interaction. So we got the highly splitted ground state, and this splitting, we believe, gives us the wide absorption continuum at the low frequencies. So this is the picture what happened in our system. At low temperatures, we just dive into this splitted region and got some new phase. But what kind of phase it could be? There are quite a lot of theoretical works on the quantum many body system with dipole interaction, but all of them only restricted to 2D, two dimensions. And in those papers, the predicted phases ranges from spin liquid to XY magnet and some ordered phases. But unfortunately, there is no solution for quantum many body system in three dimensions. Instead, you can only speculate about how our ground state might look like. And the exact nature of the exact picture of the ground state is should be clarified in the future. I come to the conclusion. Water molecules in beryl is a very good realization of angle lattice of freely rotating dipoles. Each water rotator below 50 Kelvin behaves in essentially a quantum way. And below 2K, we observed the sign of transition governed by a dipole interaction, but the exact type of ground state is not figured out yet. So, and it should be clarified in the future.
You know, when you speak about polar molecules, you mean permanent dipole in the sense of permanent in the absence of external fields, and then these permanent dipoles interact among each other via dipole-dipole interaction.
Then I'm talking about the lattice of water molecules. Water molecules have the permanent dipole, which is quite big. It's 1.8 debye. And yes, what I was talking about, it was interaction of permanent dipoles of water molecules without any external fields.